What's good, y'all? You're back with Streets, Freestyle Cooking with Streets. Thanks for tuning in. Like always, I hope everybody out there staying safe and healthy. And of course, y'all know what it is. Got another great recipe video to share with y'all. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Always appreciate you coming through, showing me love, checking me out. And if this is your first time on my channel, please hit that subscribe, like, share, and hit that notification bell so you can stay up to date with my latest recipe videos. You feel me? Come through, check me out, man. Got some dope recipes on the channel that you can try out at home for your friends and guests and family and get it in. It's what we do here, Freestyle Cooking. Let's do it. All right, so today, y'all, I'm doing like a real quick simple recipe because I just got this steel made griddle that I'm excited to have. I've used it a few times. We're gonna do a little quick curry chicken on the griddle, you know what I mean? So I can show y'all what this griddle look like, man. Maybe y'all can go out and get one, man. Or do, if y'all got a griddle in y'all backyard, do y'all thing. But just wanted to share with y'all my likings of the griddle. Real quick, easy recipe, man. I got some chicken breasts up here. Got me some vegetables, some carrots, some broccoli. We're gonna do all this on the griddle. Real easy. Real simple. Let's do it. First thing is I got me some water boiling, so I'm gonna go ahead and actually boil these for a bit because I just want to go ahead and like kind of blanch them real strong and then take it to the griddle. Okay, so you want to have some water boiling on the side. If you're doing this exact recipe, add some water on the side, get your vegetables prepared and ready. We're only gonna put them in the water for a few minutes. Got my water boiling. Let's put these to the side. All right, now next, I got me some chicken breasts here. Two chicken breasts. I got them in this freezer bag because I'm gonna go ahead and pound them down just to thin them out a little bit because it was like real big chicken breasts. And I'm just gonna thin them out just a little bit. Just so it'll give me a little bit, it'll cook quicker on the griddle. Cause you don't want to cook it too long on the griddle because you don't want it to dry out. All right, so this will kind of help give you some juicy breasts. All right, now I got me a bowl. Put about a tablespoon, maybe a couple, cause I'm using two big breasts. I'm not cooking a whole lot of chicken, so. Got about a couple tablespoons of olive oil in there. I'm also going to add a teaspoon of chicken seasoning. Like I got the, like the bouillon seasoning. Also want to I got some hot curry powder. You can use whatever curry powder you like. I'm going to go ahead and put a teaspoon of that in. Next, I got me some herbs de Provence. A blend of different herbs. Go ahead and put a little bit of that in there, which is optional. I just want some herbs with my curry chicken. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get this mixed up real good, like so. Alright, so now I got my breasts up out the bag, pounded them down where I like it. Now I'm just gonna spread this all over my breasts. Alright, both sides. Real simple, real easy, y'all. You know what I mean? Like I said, I love those griddles, and you're about to see it in a minute. We about to get it in. Definitely should look to get in one, man. I'm already feeling like it's a must-have. All right, so there we go. Boom! So here it is, you guys. My flat-top griddle. Company is still made. Feel me? I came across this by accident online. I forget what I was looking at, but soon as I seen it, I had to get it because I always wanted to get a griddle, to put outside next to the barbecue grill, but I wanted one
or I could use it inside too, just because I just, you know, because the gas, and you always got to have gas for the griddle outside. So this right here, it's perfect, fits over top of my burners, as you can see. Has a little drip tray right there that goes under that. And as you can see, I got a little patina going, because I've used it a few times. When you first get it, it'd be like super clean, seasoned. So obviously, you know, you season it like cast iron, and it's popping, y'all. All right, so what I want to do is I want to heat it up. So I'll start with putting my burners on low, and I'm heating up both sides, because I'm only probably going to use one side, but I'm heating up both sides just so I don't warp my griddle. Okay, well, once I got it hot, because the heat starts to spread, once I get it hot, I can shut it down on one side. Okay. So, you know, when you get one of these, you'll play with it to get to the kind of temp you want. Okay. Get yourself a temp gun like this. Alright. See, we can take the temp. Yeah, we can take the temp. And I kind of want to wait till it gets about 350, 70, around that range, because we're going to do a really quick sear, a few minutes on each side, depending on the size of your breast. I pounded them down just to take it down on the time of having to sear my breast, okay? So, while my breast is chilling, and we letting this heat up, we'll come back, y'all. Let's do it! Okay, let's check the temp again. Okay. All right. Okay, got it there at 400 right there. This is about 395. That's cool. All right. So I'm just go ahead and turn it up just a little bit more, because like I said, don't be afraid of the high heat. You want to get a good, really good sear. Okay, I'm gonna keep this side just still flowing. I'm gonna use that for my vessel. Okay. Right. Got me some oil here. Always keep a high heat point oil that can handle the heat. Go ahead and spread it out. Alright. Alright, let me get my chicken. Oh yeah, y'all. That's right. Now we're going to go ahead and sear these a good at least four. With these side breasts I got, I'm going to do about 4 or 5 minutes on each side. Okay? Get this chicken nice and juicy. There we go. About to do our first flip. Oh yeah, look at that. Looking nice. Oh yeah. Also got this grill press, so we're gonna add that there just to keep the juices trapped up inside there, give us a nice good even cook. All right, about another four or five minutes, because we looking real nice right now. Some of y'all got to have this now. Wow, that's almost done. Let's go ahead and get my vegetables. Okay, got my vegetables. Alright, get them on. There we go, y'all. I'm just gonna lightly grill these up. Like I said, I done already blanched them real good. Alright, I'm just gonna get a nice little flow on them. Alright, now you can see I got my my vegetables in the cool zone. I had turned that spot off. Right here, easy clean, some water. Scrape it up. Real easy clean, y'all. Alright, Go ahead and shut that side down. Let those cool off. Chicken almost finished. Look at that, y'all. I'm gonna just do one more flip, but you can see how you got that nice color going on right there. And that's it. I'm good. I just flipped it. Might be do it one more time for like a couple of minutes. These are pretty thick, bro. And take them off. We'll take our breast off. We're done. Oh yeah, look at that. Nice. Alright. So easy to clean up, get the water, scrape it up. And look at that, y'all. Easy clean. Alright. Scraped it off, a little bit of water. Oil, and this is like the flat top oil that it came with, right? You know, you want to keep your joint nice and seasoned. And I also use, you know, the regular avocado oil or whatever safflower oil I got to keep this seasoned, just like my cast iron worked for me. And there we have it. So here we go, y'all. Ready for use for the next time. Ready to go, man. Love this thing, man. Y'all gotta get it, man. Definitely would love to have it. All right. Let's get to the table. Get to the board. Plate this up. Let's do it. Boom. There we go, you guys. Got it plated on up. Got our curry chicken breast and vegetables. Just put a little bit of salt and pepper on the vegetables. But I wanted to share this video with y'all so y'all could see my griddle. Made this fantastic meal on a griddle. Check him out. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Got the nice breast. Like, I got the other one I cut up so you can see the juiciness. Look at that, y'all. Look at that. Look at all that juicy. That's how you keep a breast juicy, man. Not dried out. You feel me? So you already know what I'm about to do, man. You feel me? So please subscribe, like, share. Hit that notification bell so y'all can stay up to date with the latest videos, man. Try this. Comment on it, man. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all know what it is. Holla.